Welcome to the video news of the week. State emergency crews were kept busy this past week. While a nice storm largely missed the northern New Hampshire region, thousands of utility customers were left without power in Vermont, Maine, and the eastern townships of Quebec. Multiple vehicles went off the road in regional accidents, while other residents took to their cars for heat during the power outages, which largely began on Sunday. Throughout the day, dozens of utility trucks from NSTAR, a sister company of Public Service of New Hampshire, as well as vehicles from Ashland, could be seen lining Gould Street and the industrial park in Colebrook. Their engines were kept running, ready to be called out on a moment's notice. While northern New Hampshire missed the bulk of the storm, just above the border in the eastern townships of Quebec, freezing rain coated everything in ice. Colebrook Chronicle correspondent Corey Bellum reported that the storm left thousands in the dark, saying that the power crews were working hard to restore power, but continued to be faced with even more problems. In nearby Vermont, the towns of Newport and Barton were especially hard hit. As of last night, WCAX Channel 3 out of Burlington reported that 12,000 were still without power, which was down from the highest number of 70,000 when the storm first hit on Sunday. This picture shows some of the damage in nearby Barton, Vermont. Look for more on this in the lead story in this week's Colebrook Chronicle.
On December 22nd, the Groveton Fire Department opened its doors for their annual Christmas party. Adults and children were greeted by Santa and Mrs. Claus and treated to tables laden with food and gifts for every child in attendance. Police and fire personnel received over $1,000 in donations, which went towards the gifts that were available.
This year was a little challenging because of the weather, but we still have presents, over $1,000 of presents at generous donations. And a kid comes up with a ticket, and he gets a present. And we try to give every kid that stops today a present. Along with the presents, we have the girls. They made gingerbread cookies so that the kids could decorate their own cookies. We have food that's provided free for them to come. It's mainly to come and enjoy the holiday. It's our way of giving back to the community. Mr. and Mrs. Claus are here giving out stockings. And so our way of saying Merry Christmas.
The Pittsburgh Fire Station looked just like Santa's workshop on Friday, December 20th, after Brooks Chevrolet dropped off a trailer full of toys to the station that was acting just like a warehouse for the Toys for Tots program. Here, new unwrapped presents were sorted out by gender and age group and were ready to be delivered to the different pickup locations for families from Columbia to Pittsburgh.
And I've got one.
Hey, money.
You guys know better than me.
Oh, just...
Last Saturday morning, local clergy members and a small crowd gathered at the Kiwanis Club of Colebrook's Tree of Love on the library's front lawn for a short dedication ceremony.
Heavenly Father, whose blessed Son came not to be served, but to serve.
Provide for all their needs, sustain and comfort them, protect them from all ill, and grant them eternal joy in your service.
And in this Christmas season, may it all come together as a blessing for you. Amen.
Wrapping up holiday school concerts for this year was the Stewartstown Community Schools performance. The concert was held on December 19th and featured students from kindergarten through 8th grade.
Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer, reindeer that had a very shiny nose like the light bulb.
Last Christmas I gave you my heart, but the very next day you gave it away.
The warm sounds of the annual Tuba Christmas concert could be heard down Bridge Street in Colebrook last Saturday, December 21st. The event, which drew in a full house, was sponsored by the Great North Woods Committee for the Arts and was held at the Trinity United Methodist Church.
Townspeople gathered on the cold streets of Lac-Megantic last Wednesday to watch the first train to pass through town since the July 6th derailment. Traffic stopped and residents watched as it came through the village, carrying only 16 cars. It was a small load to test the tracks before moving on to larger hauls. This past Friday, the Sawyerville United Church held their annual Christmas dinner for the residents and church members at the Sawyerville Community Center. Food was served and music was performed, including the singing of Jack Garneau and Marlene, Janice, and Carolyn Lowry. Colebrook Chronicle Video News of the Week is sponsored by the Upper Connecticut Valley Hospital in Colebrook. Visit their website at ucvh.org. Compassionate healthcare close to home. LaPerle's IGA of Colebrook. Great deals and instant coupons can be found on their website at laperlesiga.com. Colebrook Plumbing and Heating in Colebrook. Why heat with oil when you can heat economically with wood? Come see our whole house wood boiler solutions currently on sale. Murphy's Steakhouse at Bear Tree in Pittsburgh. Enjoy casual fine dining, a cozy atmosphere, and wonderful food. Try the chef's table on Sunday evenings. And by Woodsville Guaranty Savings Bank. Friendly local people, friendly local bank. And open 7 days a week inside Lancaster Shaw's. Following the unpredictable weather of the past week, look for a weekend of mostly cloudy skies and just around freezing temperatures. Friday brings a high of 23 degrees with a low of 14. Saturday, expect a chance of snow showers with a high of 33. And Sunday also brings a high of 33 with a low of 21 degrees. Happy New Year from the Video News of the Week, and we'll see you all in 2014.